you all know, today we are missing someone. Someone who is extremely dear to us, Mr. O.A. Someone who is extremely dear to us, Mr. O.A. Buddy Franks, not only served this board, but served our community and our region in so many ways. And he will be greatly missed, not just today, but in years to come. But he loved this institution. He loved our community. And today, it's a very small token, but Gene, if you don't mind, would you mind coming up here? Just a very small token of our appreciation. We have a collage of just the wonderful moments that we had with you and Buddy over these many years, and we want to present that to you today. And also, we want to present to you his gavel, so you can keep that, because he wielded this very well. So thank you, and we want to make sure you're able to keep that for years to come. So thank you so much. We'll turn the podium over to Dr. Berry for comments. Southern Arkansas University.
Thank you very much. Well, it's been another productive semester already, these first few months. I just want to go over some things that have happened since our last meeting, and there have been many, many things. I will start off with actually last weekend. And last weekend was our homecoming. It was not just a homecoming. It was a 1915 was our first. In fact, according to James Willis in his book, it was a rainy Thanksgiving in 1915 when the Magnolia Aggies took on the Monticello Bow Eagles and won. Well, we repeated it. We took on the Oklahoma Baptist Bisons and won. It was a great, great weekend. A lot of reunions here on campus. We saw people coming back for hadn't been back in 40. 30, 25 years, so it was wonderful to see a lot of people. Mule Gatting, all record crowd there. Football game, record crowd there. Record gate receipts, Shawana, happy about that. But I'll tell you, all of our gate receipts this year have exceeded expectations, so we've had a lot more people coming to our football games and our mule gating, so that was a great thing to see, just have all those people back on campus. I'll tell you also some academic news. Our Ted Monroe Farm down the Red River is extremely active. In fact, as we speak right now, they are harvesting soybeans. The combines are rolling right now, and a lot of our agri students have really gone down and taken hold of that farm and really have learned a lot. In fact, next week they're going to have a big harvest celebration down there, and a large number of our agri students are going to go down for that harvest celebration there on the Ted Monroe Farm, but it's been a great thing happening. Also in front of you, you will see something else that we thought was worthy of your attention, and that is Lockheed Martin has created an internship slot just for SAU engineering students, and that will start in the spring of 2016. But we're really happy with that partnership, and who knows where it'll go from there. So we're really excited about that partnership. Also, Also, you may have heard about this. We sent out a notice about it, but we were picked as the number 6 most affordable small college in the nation. Not Arkansas, not the South, but in the nation. And believe me, we are going to use that in recruitment. We really feel so fortunate, and it's also a recognition of how we've tried to keep our costs down over the years, and hopefully we continue to do that and see where we might move up on that ranking. So we're excited about that. We're also starting some new recruitment efforts. This is a picture of our latest foray into Cabot. We had a wonderful reception for teachers and students at Cabot High School. Had a great turnout. We're really focusing on Central Arkansas and trying to pave some new territory there, some new frontiers. So we're having some success there in Cabot, Jacksonville, Little Rock. We're also doing some target marketing through social media in those areas. Aaron Street and his team are doing some wonderful things there. And target market, don't ask me how it works, but it's working. And it's absolutely been wonderful. We're having some billboards in Central Arkansas and everything, so we're trying to get exposure in some new areas of the state. Of course, I guess the big news of today is what you guys are going to discuss in a few minutes, the possibility of new residence halls. This is just one mock-up of what it could look like, or they could look like. And as you know, we have been bursting at the seams as far as attendance, and so we feel the time is right for new residence halls. What we're proposing is 2 halls, something like this, that will be 132 beds in each hall, 264 total. We are looking at a site, and if you look over here, you see the football field, the track. This is straight across the street from the football field. It will be in that general area. The 2 blue buildings are the ones proposing to build first, with a possible 3rd, if luckily we're lucky enough to keep this enrollment growth going. But parking all the way along, around the side, parking that could have dual purpose, and also helping us with parking during football games and things like that. So that's our proposal, and you guys will be looking at examining a ground lease. And I want to say that we are very fortunate to be partnering with our Alumni Association on this. They've been very gracious to help us in this endeavor. I want to thank David Butler for his leadership in this, because that has helped us expedite this whole process to have some dormitories and residence halls ready by the fall of 2016, because I will tell you, we will need them. We will need them, for sure. There's the inside, a spec of the inside. It is dormitory style. It is not apartment style. We do have residence halls, as you know, that are apartment style. So if students like that kind of living, we have that kind of living. But this will be a dormitory style, as you see. And then fundraising. It's been very active. Josh Key and his team have been very active in fundraising. And I will tell you that over the 3rd quarter of this year, our alumni giving has gone up 38% just in the 3rd quarter of this year. And our overall individual giving has gone up almost 10% just in the 3rd quarter. So there's been enormous activity going on. One of the things that Josh thought up, and this is a wonderful thing, we heard something about this at a conference we went to in San Antonio. It's called the Power 5. In fact, that's Josh's idea. What we're looking at are students, graduates, who've only been out for 5 years. And what we're asking them to do is to give $5 to SAU. That gets them in the pipeline. That starts us able to steward those students and to help them really feel good about giving back to the institution. We've already had great success with that. We had a table set up at homecoming, and we had a lot of our alums that have been out just recently sign up for this. So, and I will tell you, it's all electronic. It's a campaign. It's all electronic. Nothing in print. It's all social media, Twitter, other things like that, and it's working. It's working very well. I will tell you also that we're in the midst of receiving proposals about a feasibility study for a major fundraising campaign that we hope to launch this time next year.
But we will look at those feasibility studies from different agencies and see which will fit SAU the best, and hopefully pick a group that will help us, direct us in that way to try to help raise some good, needed revenue for the institution. This is another, some of our recent grads right here with the Power of Five. They've been very, very gracious of their time and their resources. We had El Dorado's reception since our last time we met, which was very successful. We really want to really increase our bond between El Dorado and Union County. We expected to have about 120 people come to the reception. We had over 200 come to the reception. So it was a great example of not just alums, but friends there in El Dorado, and we hope to capitalize on that in the future. We will, this week, be playing in the Murphy USA Classic against ODU in El Dorado, and we'll be mule-gating there on West Avenue in El Dorado. So we're going to try to do as many new things with El Dorado to increase our relationship with them. And that's all I have for my report. I think Dr. Lankin, I think he has something to share as well.
Thank you, Dr. Berry. I'd like to touch on the economic development. The following economic development projects have been worked on since July 1st, 2015. As you're aware of, the Lockheed Martin JLTV project, we have gathered and provided information from various sources on buildings and land availability in various cities in the surrounding areas. Lockheed was not awarded the contract, but they're in the appeal process. The appeal will take 100 days, and if I have it calculated right, it should hear something in December, whether or not their appeal was successful. Airjet Rocketdyne, we attended the groundbreaking ceremony for their new pad building, as well as the 12 megawatt solar field dedication. If you're not aware of it, their solar field is coming right along. It should be finished by the end of the year. It's 180 acres of solar panels. If you get a chance to go by, it does make an impression on you. They look like they're making hay while the sun shines, so to speak, because it was so wet the first month that they were there. Sure, they thought that they'd never be able to get their panels out, but they did. I attended a congressional reception for Arkansas Representatives Bruce Westerman, French Hill, Steve Womack, and Louisiana Representative Steve Scalise. This was about 2 weeks before the JLTV announcement. All four congressmen were at the Highland House in East Camden. We provided the USDA Emergency Watershed Protection Assistance information to Ouachita County Judge Robbie McAdoo at his request. We attended the Camden Area Chamber of Commerce open membership meeting at Camden Fairview High School. We met with representatives of the Fairview High School Gym Restoration Committee and provided a tour of water systems in the area with Chase Emerson, representing Senator Bozeman's office, and Ben Gilmore, representing Congressman Westerman's office. We provided a tour of SAU Tech to ADHE Director Brent Powell, who has made it a point to visit all campuses in Arkansas, and we were certainly blessed that we were early on his visitation schedule. We provided a tour of Highland Industrial Park with special attention on the Arkansas Fire Training Academy to Chase Emerson and Ben Gilmore. They have an interest from the congressional area and the Fire Academy, and we've responded to several inquiries from state senators and representatives. Fundraising projects that we've worked on since July 1st at Tech, Woods Place soft opening, monetary donations were given to the SAU Tech Foundation, the 2016 STAR campaign, employee giving to SAU Tech Foundation is underway, and the Governor's Workforce Cabinet Aerospace Defense Sector Certification Pathways Planning Grant was awarded. Any questions?